Dear friends, allow me to greet you all with these warm greetings so loved by Saint Francis. May the Lord give you peace. The Feast of Saint Francis, which occurs on the 4th of October, is dear to many Catholics in the world because this saint is the one who, above all, enabled us to understand the humility and love of God. He who became a child in Bethlehem, died for us on the cross, and rose on the third day, opening for us the way to heaven. October 4th is an opportunity for us to commemorate the life of Saint Francis, the son of a rich merchant from Assisi, born in 1182 and died in 1226. After dreaming of glory on the battlefields, he instead finds the meaning of life in embrace of a leper, in prayer before the crucifix of San Damiano, and in listening to the Gospel during the celebration of the Mass at Santa Maria degli Angeli, Our Lady of the Angels, at the Pociuncola. We all remember him so well as he sings of a universal brotherhood, inviting all creatures to praise the most high, almighty, and good God. The sun and the moon, earth and water, wind and fire, but also sickness and death, are brothers and sisters for him. In a time of violent struggles between individuals, between families, between cities, nations, and civilizations, Francis sings of forgiveness and reconciliation. Of course, this feast is celebrated in a special way in Italy, Pope Pius XII, proclaiming him patron of Italy, recognized him as the most Italian of saints and the holiest of Italians. To honor him, every year one of the regions of Italy goes on pilgrimage to his tomb and offers oil for the lamp that shines in the crypt of the Basilica of St. Francis. The Feast of St. Francis naturally reminds us of his transitus, that is to say, his passing from this world to the next, recalling his death, which took place at Santa Maria degli Angeli, Our Lady of the Angels at the Pociuncola, on the evening of the 3rd of October 1226, and lived out like an Easter passing from this world to the life in God. A death lived praising God and blessing the brothers. He joyfully greeted and embraced the death as a sisters and as the door to true life. As St. Francis recalls in his testament, the experience of encountering lepers, praying in the silence of the churches, and listening to the Gospel was fundamental for him. All this took place in 1206, when Francis was a young man of 24. Immediately afterwards, a group of young people from Assisi asked to join him to share the same form of life. They are the first friars minor. From that small group, the order of friars minor was born, currently present in more than 100 countries around the world, and branched out into Franciscan friars minor, conventuals, and capuchins. The order of the poor sisters, or poor clares, as we call them, was born from the meeting between St. Francis and the young noble of Assisi, Chiara Claire degli Offreducci, in 1211, who will make their center in San Damiano. From the meeting with a married couple from Poggibonsi, Lucchese, and his wife Bona, the Franciscan Third Order was born, reserved especially for lay people who wish to live the spirituality of St. Francis. Amongst these, St. Elizabeth of Hungary and St. Louis IX, King of France, will stand out for their holiness. Just 2 years after his death, Pope Gregory IX, a friend of St. Francis while he was alive, proclaimed him a saint and laid the first stone of that extraordinary treasure chest of faith and art that is the Basilica of St. Francis in Assisi, where the body of St. Francis was laid to rest in 1230 and is currently a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It is my wish that you are able to joyfully celebrate the Feast of St. Francis on the 4th of October. I wish that, like the poverello, the poor man of Assisi, that you may become stronger in loving and following Jesus and his gospel, loving the church and serving the poor and those most in need, and knowing how to recognize in every human being and in every creature a brother and a sister. I wish you to learn even more how to become tireless operators of reconciliation and peace like him, in order that one day you may be welcomed into heaven with the Virgin Mary and all the saints. May I take opportunity to conclude by invoking upon you the blessing so dear to St. Francis. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. And may the Lord bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.